but really came into the business initially as a specialist on technical subjects, and that was aircraft. And of course, Gene Roddenberry and I immediately found common ground. All he told me about the show was that it was out in the future, and I don't want to see any fire, flame, or fins. I don't want to see any fire, flame, or fins. So then I went down and spent a bunch of Lucy's money on Flash Gordon and Buck Rogers. And all of that I put on one wall and said, that I will not do. That I will not do.
And something else he wanted was not so many people sitting, as he put it, hunched over their instruments waiting for something to happen. He wanted it to be a much more relaxed working environment. A lot of softer colors, earth tones. It was my own mission to soften the bridge look up, give it a more comfortable feel.
We're looking also more towards marine architecture and submarine architecture. These are just large naval vessels. This is kind of the space navy. We were so intrigued to make the Shenzhou with this almost kind of authoritative view of the universe.
It's not right. This is not a ship of war. This is a ship of peace.
Starfleet is not a military organization. Its purpose is exploration.
I loved that philosophy. I thought it not only noble, but absolutely enduring. Why do you think Star Trek has been so fantastically successful?
I think the reason that the franchise has been so successful for 30-something years, well, the thing that makes it so unique as well, is because it's an optimistic view of the future. Everything else that we see is so pessimistic and so dark and so nihilistic. And this shows a positive portrayal of what could be in the future. And I think people need that and want that, and want that to grasp onto.
Because they're smart. And we are noble and pure of spirit as a species.
Humans are capable of so much more than we yet understand. We're really something. Star Trek fans believe that. And so do I.